Hello and welcome to BCHL Wrap-Up. I'm your host, Tally Campbell, here on iNet Online. We take a look at Seb Lloyd's hidden talent, the Island Sports News Spotlight of the Week. We've got news and scores, that and more. You're watching BCHL Wrap-Up. As you may be well aware, there's brand new changes here coming to BCHL Wrap-Up. Of course, one of them being the new name. We have a brand new graphics, and we have brand new partners for the Island Sports News, which we'll talk about a little bit later on in the show. Earlier this season, we spoke to Seb Lloyd of the West Kelowna Warriors. We've learned that he has a hidden talent. Chrissy Farrell of the West Kelowna Warriors finds out.
So you like singing karaoke. That's interesting, because, you know, usually manly men, big hockey players, don't like to wail it out. What kind of music do you like? Like AC/DC, Led Zeppelin, what are you singing?
I'm into the soft stuff. I like the Fray, the Script.
So when you're singing karaoke, what kind of tunes do you like to sing?
I like some of the old boy bands, NSYNC, Backstreet Boys, stuff like that.
Can we get a sample? Come on!
Probably need some music.
You ready to sing that, Princess?
You are my fire, the one desire, believe when I say I want it that way. But we are two worlds apart, can't reach to your heart when
I want it that way.
Tell me why you ain't nothing but a heartache.
Tell me why
you ain't nothing but a mistake.
Tell me why
I never wanna hear you say
I want it that way. I want it that way.
Well, that was good. I'd say a little bit awkward. I don't think I felt that awkward since I went on that date with Coach Furster.
Yeah, well, I've seen a couple of his girlfriends, and they're pretty good looking.
He's a good looking coach. If you look at the caliber of the other coaches in the league, like, I've seen some of them. Yeah. So coming up for you next year, you've got another season, you know, with the Warriors. One thing, you know, because Frenchie's going to be gone.
Yeah.
The C's open, right? Is that what you're gunning for, the big C?
I don't know about that.
No?
I mean, obviously you hope to be a leader on the team next year, but being a captain or not being a captain, I'll try and do my job.
But think about it. You could sing the plays to all the players before the game. You could do like a warm-up karaoke to get everyone in the vibe.
Yeah, Diener might have to watch out his job because I might be taking intermission promotions, doing like Jackie Moon on semi-pro, singing karaoke in the intermissions or something.
What is one thing we need to know about you? Something that we wouldn't know otherwise until you told us. Like, spill a secret.
I have a crush on Christy Farrell.
No, actually, you told me Max French's mom. He's just hiding that little secret now, but I'll share it with all of you. Hey, you're not alone. That's pretty much the consensus.
I'm pretty sure the whole team does, so.
Oh, there you go. Max French's mom comes up again. Yeah.
Not sure if I'd call that a hidden talent or not, but thank you to Christy Farrell of the West Kelowna Warriors for that interview/talent. It's now time to take a look at the news in the BCHL for October 28th. In discipline news, the Trail Smoke Eaters' Scott Davison is suspended 2 games for receiving a major penalty blow to the head. The Langley Rivermen's Austin Azzurdi is assessed a 2-game suspension for receiving a major penalty blow to the head. And Palmer Kings' Luke Nogard is suspended 2 games for receiving a major penalty for blow to the head. Only one trade this week, and it was an in-league trade, as the Spruce Kings acquired the playing rates of Michael Lavanna, 94 forward, from the Vernon Vipers in exchange for future considerations. That was the only trade in the BCHL this week. And a new segment we're bringing here on BCHL Wrap-Up is the Island Sports News Spotlight Player of the Week. This week's sponsored on Burnie Valley Bulldogs rookie, Brett Stewart. Brett hails from Calgary, Alberta, but grew up playing hockey in Penticton, BC. His favorite NHL team is the Calgary Flames, and his favorite NHL player is Mark Giordano. His goal in life is to one day become an NHL coach, and his goal this season as a rookie for the Alberni Valley Bulldogs to make the playoffs. This week's Island Sports News Player Spot of the Week was on Brett Stewart of the Alberni Valley Bulldogs. Score recap time in the BCHL. We begin things on Wednesday afternoon when the Chilliwack Chiefs were taking on the Langley Rivermen.
And the Langley Rivermen beat the Chilliwack Chiefs 4-3.
Picking up the action on November 1st on Friday, the Bernie Valley Bulldogs beat the Quitman Express 6-4. Prince George snuck out the victory against the Surrey Eagles 3-2. Merritt beat the Chilliwack Chiefs 7-2. Vernon snuck out the victory against Salmon and Silverbacks 2-1. The Clippers beat Powell River Hat Park Arena 4-3. And the Trail Smoke Eaters tied with the Victoria Grizzlies 4-4. And now on Saturday, November the 2nd, Powell River beat the Nanaimo Clippers 4-1. The Trail Smoke Eaters snuck away with a victory 5-1 against the West Kelowna Warriors. The Alberni Valley Bulldogs lost to Surrey Eagles 4-2. The Victoria Grizzlies beat the Salmon River Silverbacks 3-2. The Land River beat the Prince George Spruce Kings in overtime 3-2. And the Merritt Snails against the Chilliwack Chiefs are game of the week. Merritt won 3-2. There was three games on tap for Sunday afternoon. The Victoria Grizzlies beat the Vernon Vipers 4-3 in overtime. Kevin Massey scoring the game-winning goal. The Nanaimo Clippers beat the Cowichan Valley Capitals with a big stick 4-2. Mason Mitchell scoring 2 goals. And the Alberni Valley Bulldogs beat the Chilliwack Chiefs 8-5. Hunter Stewart combining for 4 points, 2 goals, and 2 assists. Your bookkeeping and income tax solution, go to www.sienna.com for more information. This is Wilshire Sienna at Scoreboard.
The BCHL wrap-up game of the week this week is on Saturday afternoon when the Chilliwack Chiefs took on the Merritt Centennials on November 2nd.
Chiefs almost get one late. McNaughton with 8 seconds. Another slap shot. Scores! Keeper McNaughton through a crowd. Parry back the other way over the Chilliwack line. Left side, Patterson redirects. He scores. Scott Patterson set up by Sebastian Parry. Great play by the Saints off the rush and the counterattack. Centennial setting up at the power play here. Pulse into the middle. Martin fakes the slap shot. Goes for James Neal in the left circle, being played physically by TJ Roche along the boards. As TJ's back in the lineup tonight. Neal left circle, a shot. He scores. James Neal through a crowd. Went 5-hole on Stanwood, who I don't think saw it. So the Centennials have struck and the power corner ensues. Roberts can't dig it out. Comes right to Martin. He scores. Tyler Martin in the left circle. That puck came right out to him. I'm not sure if it came off a Chilliwack stick or not. Left side into the middle. Jake Clifford. Peyton Schaefer. Back for Jake Clifford into the middle between the circles. Patterson a shot. He scores. Scott Patterson. High to the blocker's side on Josh Halpiny. Another power play goal for Merritt. Their power play has exploded. 15 seconds to go in the period. Rush, left side. Cochran, left circle. Cross ice. D'Amantoni in front. Tibbett scores. Nice look by Zach D'Amantoni. Matthew Tibbett with the goal. Hey, Patterson, high slot in the Chilliwack zone. Wrist shot. He scores. Halpiny got a piece of it. Cooper Rush kind of stopped on the play as the puck hopped over the pad of Halpiny and rolled over the goal line. A 6-2 Merritt lead with 4:52. It's Diego Cuglietta. Cuglietta wins the battle. Centers it in front. They score. Another goal for the Centennials. Side of the net, it's Gavin Gould getting in on the fun. It's 7-2 with 3:19 to go. They knock off Chilliwack by a score of 7-2 on a night where Chilliwack simply was just not good enough against a good Merritt hockey team.
It's now my favorite time of the show where we do the BCHL wrap-up photo contest.
David Stanford is our photo challenge winner this week. That is a photo before the calm before the storm in a BCHL arena.
Congratulations, you are the winner of a $20 Starbucks gift card. Remember, you can be a winner. All you gotta do is tweet us your hockey photos at BCHL Wrap-Up. Thank you for watching this edition of BCHL Wrap-Up, your first edition of BCHL Wrap-Up. Have yourself a fantastic night. We'll see you all next week. That, my friends, that's a wrap.